extreme heat, Fenyx carried on undeterred, plunging the hammer of Hephaestus into the heart of the fire.
Prometheus, this is pushing it. No human could dream of holding that hammer.
Or holding your lightning? And yet, absorbing the power of the flames, the hammer came alive. And with it, Fenyx released the second of Hephaestus' blessings. With the hammer revived, and Hephaestus' suffering trapped below, all Fenyx had to do now was jump.
Maybe I was a chef.
Fenyx felt a chill in the air of the vault, but was more than cold.
Sorry, that's my new cologne. It's by Porius, the North Wind.
I know, he's my cousin.
Oh, and he didn't even hook you up. Eyes cold.
The air moves so strangely. I wonder if I could use that to help me get around. It looks like I can change the wind's direction.
Mother, no! I can change! I'll be the son you want! Forget your quest. Walk unburdened. Let Typhon take us. Undo the cruelty we have wreaked. I will live in the flame, and it will not consume me. How could you? I trusted you. Therapies! Brontes! I trusted you!
Mother!
Just as you had packaged the torments of the world to so kindly give to humanity, Fenyx would trap Hephaestus' torments inside Pandora's box. His suffering, his tortured inspirations.
My kid's an artist, what can I say?
Strife, the darkest emotion that plagued Hephaestus, was trapped safely again in Pandora's box.
Strife? So his wife doesn't love him and he was forced into exile for years. That's not so bad.
I'm married to Hera.
Inflicted upon Hephaestus emerged.
Malice? What malice? Hephaestus had it easy.
Well, you threw him off Mount Olympus, his mother rejected him, the gods mocked him, no one invited him to dinner, or if they did, they'd change plans at the last minute.
I'm busy, Prometheus. It happens.
Take my past! Set me free! Come home! I'll do anything! Anything!
I will always be the disfigured god.
Thank you.
Despair emerged from the illuminated flame, and Phoenix was quick to return it to Pandora's box.
All the forges are lit. The air should be strong enough to carry me up now.
Look at Hephaestus. Someone like him, he should have just settled. He's the one who held Hera hostage, demanding Aphrodite's hand. I knew she would never touch him. She would be safe and unavailable. It was perfect. So I agreed. He brought despair on himself.
Its heft was heavy, as was Phoenix's worry. By retrieving these dark memories and returning them to Hephaestus, was he dooming him to misery? The question haunted him as he continued.
Mother! Father! Please stop! I'll behave! I promise! Aphrodite, just talk to me.
Yeah.
Cold all of a sudden. I almost feel sad.
Vengeance seed, as did the rage that comes with it. You see, for every misdeed you put upon him, Hephaestus let his rage burn, channeling it into a force for good, his many creations.
Life was never going to be easy for the boy. I was trying to make him strong. I didn't realize how much I hurt him.
Malice, strife, despair and vengeance merged, and together became Hephaestus' locked away essence made whole.
Hephaestus, I'm back, and I have your essence. Hephaestus?
Phoenix hoped Hephaestus was at the Hall of the Gods.
Yes, gigantic lady?
I say, this is all over. We commission you to restore the Golden Isle to its former glory.
But with more paintings!
Another appreciator? Things are really coming up mean lately.
Cheap, hideous art splayed across the once beautiful land.
I shall call the project Get Rid of My Husband, or GROMH for short. I'm still working on the name. You have to come up with something short and snappy that people can chant.
You're here. When I came out of the vault, I thought something happened.
Something's always happening.
Something bad. How did you get here?
I might have helped. You made my winged helmet and sandals. I saved you and brought you here. So, you know, we're even.
He thinks we met before. Just play along.
Yes! Your sandals! I'm glad you like your sandals!
Oh, I tried. Did you find his essence?
You sure you're ready for this?
Nothing bad has ever happened ever. Why would it start now?
Father of invention, lend me your sword, your spear, your arrow. Transform the darkness to light our way.
Welcome back, old friend.
You okay, big guy?
I remember everything.
Give it time. There's one thing I still don't understand. With no memory, how did you leave clues leading to Typhon's vault?
Not Typhon's. Mine. I suffered so long, I was so tired. Before Typhon came, I used Pandora's box many times to trap my inner torments in that vault. I had a system. I created the clues so I could find my way back. Typhon found me defenseless. I let that monster turn me into one of my automatons. I even enjoyed it.
Because automatons feel nothing at all. But your clues. You should have been able to retrieve your own essence.
Steropes and Brontes, my assistants, double-crossed me. They took the first clue. The one directing me to light the forge fires and burned it.
No, there's nothing more evil than irony.
In doing so, they made sure my prison was permanent.
I know those names. Each is a legendary Cyclops. If I find them, I will make sure they pay for what they did.
Good. They stole armor I'd been forging. Consider it yours. And speaking of payment, I at least owe this. You're going to need it for what we must do next. We're going to steal something.
Oh, yes!
To protect Hope from the clumsiness and sorrow of mortals, Zeus hid its fragile form somewhere near my forge. There, behind the locked door, Hope waits. We must release it.
If we're talking heist, I'm interested.
I hid the key in the northeast of the forge lands, in a shrine.
Let me guess, under the mat? The best place to hide something.
But even if I can steal the key and find a hidden chamber near the forge, how do we release Hope?
Together. That box is now ready for its task. May the light of a thousand forges guide your way.